Welcome to part three. Now they say every man has his price. Yeah, every man, every human being has his or her price. Yeah, and that is the truth. Now the first time I heard this saying or this truism about life, I was in high school and I rubbished it. Yeah, in my mind I said, of course I didn't dare tell the our English literature teacher anything, yeah. But I just rubbished it in my mind. And I was telling myself, no, I know somebody who has no price. Yeah, and of course I was referring to my lecturer. My politics lecturer, of course, yeah. Now, there are many times when his life was threatened, yeah. He would even walk around with a gun to protect himself, expecting at any time to be gunned down by the Kiambu mafia, yeah. But he still could not change his stand, okay? If he had ordered for some contraband, yeah, illegal coffee to be impounded, yeah, he had given that order. He was not going to give an order for it to be released, even if they threatened his life, yeah? And so it forced his boss, his direct boss, the commissioner of the police at that time, to go and release those goods, yeah? He didn't care that actually this illegal coffee belonged to somebody very senior right inside State House. Yeah? It didn't matter. So to me, sitting in high school, I said, yeah, that man is a man who has no he has no price. Yeah? Because if he does not fear death, if he prefers to stick to his principles rather than die, he prefers to die rather than abandon his principles, that is a man who has no price. That's what I used to tell myself. But of course, older and wiser now, I know that that statement is absolutely true. Because definitely, if somebody took the time, they would have found a weakness in the old man, yeah, my political lecturer. Perhaps, if they had come and held a gun to my head, I'm sure my political lecturer would have changed his mind. So the long and short of it is that every man has their price. That is true. And so, the long and short of all these people changing direction and all of a sudden talking about 2022 is that simple truism. That all that has happened is that the ruling Jubilee government has found the price of key individuals within NASA. It is really as simple as that. Yeah. Now, price can be money, price can be blackmail, price can be whatever it takes to get you to change your mind, whatever it takes to get you to do what they want. Yeah. To quote the old mafia Don Corleone adage, yeah, we're going to make him an offer he cannot refuse. And so the long and short of what has happened here is that people have been made offers they cannot refuse. It's as simple as that. And it doesn't have to be money. Sometimes the most effective thing, very effective, which I've been mentioning in this channel frequently, very frequently recently, is something called a file at the NIS. Your file at the National Intelligence Service. Yeah? So you're there, you're sitting there, you want to do what is right for the cause, you want to do what is right for the country, yeah? You want electoral justice. And then this guy comes and he starts waving like a file at you. Now, the contents of this file are such that you break into a sweat immediately. Yeah, this is a very high-stakes game. Politics is always dirty, but the higher the stakes, the dirtier the game gets. That is the truth. Now, there's another political analyst I have a lot of respect for, yeah? Because a lot of what he says makes a lot of sense. But this time round, I respectfully disagree with what he's saying, okay? What he's saying is that he believes one Musalia Mudavadi has been approached and he has been told, you're our man for 2022, okay? This, he has been told that, he believes that Musalia has been told that he should abandon NASA, yeah? And is going to be supported by the powers that be, yeah? The people propagating electoral injustice, yeah? The people able to get onto a computer and do pop, 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 and you're president of Kenya. Those guys, yeah? They've told him you're our man for 2022 because you're reasonable. You're not radical. You think straight. Yeah, you're cool. You're acceptable to everybody. And therefore should be the next president of Kenya. So just abandon NASA and do 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Do as we say. And the presidency is yours. Yeah. We know you missed it in 2012. Yeah. And we're sorry for that. You know, things just happened. Yeah. But this time around, we'll make sure you're the next president. Now, this is what this analyst believes. And he says, actually, the analyst quite rightly warns Msadia, do not be cheated. Yeah. Because this, even the person you're up against, who is going for the same office, a man called William Samoei Ruto, will not take this just standing, sitting there. Yeah, he's going to react. And you're not capable of dealing with Ruto. Yeah, that is the theory of another political analyst. But in my view, I respectfully disagree. Yeah, I disagree because Musalia Mudavadi is very intelligent. He cannot fall for something like that. Okay, and of course, he's also able to read the writing of the wall, which is very clear. Yeah, and he knows for a fact that nobody can guarantee you anything right now for 2022. The way the political situation is in the country, nobody can give you any guarantees for 2022. Indeed, nobody can give you any guarantees for 2018. Yeah, that's what it is. Let alone 2022. 2018, nobody, except God Almighty himself, can give you any guarantees for 2018. That is really what it is. And I believe Musalia knows that and acknowledges that. So I tend to believe that other methods have been used to persuade and change the views and opinions of major NASA principals. That is my view. Of course, I appreciate the fact that I could be wrong. But based on the information I have, based on what I know right now, I disagree. Yeah? I can imagine there are a lot of high fives going around now in the Jubilee High Command. Yeah, they think that they've won a victory. They think that now we've destroyed NASA, all is going to be well. Okay, but I have some very bad news for them. And the news I have for them is in the form of a kasong. You remember that kasong? Yeah, it's just the beginning. Yeah, it's not the end. Yeah, things will never be the same again. That is my simple message. And I'm not making up this stuff, yeah? So let me just give you one very clear example. In the run-up to the January 30th swearing-in of Raila Odinga, what happened is that a man called Kalonzo Musyoka was talking about negotiations. In fact, he was using the swearing-in as a bargaining chip. He was using it to threaten the Jubilee government. Looking back, it's now very clear, okay? Because what he was saying is that either you sit down and negotiate or I'll be sworn in. Yeah. But of course, now we know that he had no intentions of being sworn in. What renowned diplomat Kalonzo wanted were negotiations. Okay. Now, the interesting thing and my point here is, what was the feeling amongst the Akamba nation? The truth is, they were not with him on that one. Yeah. They were not for negotiations. Yes. They were one voice along with all the other Nasarites in saying that if there are any negotiations going to be held, they're going to be held between two presidents, yeah, President Raila Odinga and President Uhuru Kenyatta. And of course, this could only happen after the swearing-in. That was the view of the Akamba nation. And so all manner of leaders can come out claiming to represent a community, including some who are coming out of the woodwork because they abandoned the party they now seem to be staunchly supporting again, yeah. But it does not matter, because what matters are the votes on the ground. What matters are the people, and the people have really taken over. I keep saying that. Yeah, it may not be very clear now, although it should, but haeleweki, itaeleweka. Yeah. And so unfortunately for the Jubilee government, we have passed that era of waving files, okay, where leaders are concerned. Yeah, because you wave the file, you get the leader to pull in your direction, but he's pulling alone. You get the leader in your camp, but he's in your camp alone. Take the case of Otuoma and Babu. Yeah? Babu Namamba. Yeah, both from the same direction, yeah, the Busia. Okay? These people crossed over to Jubilee. Yeah? And you'd have thought, because these were very popular politicians, you'd have thought that their people would have crossed over with them. They didn't. You'd have thought that their crossing over would have made a dent in their community. It did not. Their communities are still firmly behind the cause for change, the cause for electoral justice. Yeah. So they crossed over alone. So it's the same thing with what's happening with Wiper. Wiper will cross over to the Jubilee side alone. Musalia, and indeed the Amani party, minus the so-called rebels, will cross over to Jubilee. They will do what Jubilee wants, but they're basically alone. Yeah, the Luhya nation is not following. That is for sure. Now, I love my country with all my heart, and I'm for a better Kenya. Yeah, and therefore electoral justice is very close to my heart. Okay, and therefore maybe I should be mourning. Yeah, after what has happened within NASA, or rather what has happened to NASA, but I'm not. In fact, I'm celebrating. This baby shower celebration is major as far as I'm concerned, because something very major has happened in Kenyan politics. Okay, things have changed, but some people have still not realized that things have changed. Indeed, it is comical and hilarious because somebody is rushing at full speed towards the goal to score, yeah, but they've not realized they don't have the ball. How are they going to score? Yeah, they think that they still have the ball under their feet. They think they're running with the ball. Lakini ball ilienda zamani. It's with somebody else. So when they reach the goal line and they prepare to shoot, is when they'll realize they don't have the ball. Ilienda zamani. That's really what it is. And that is why I'm really celebrating the baby shower. Okay? And I'm even celebrating this song, yeah, which I finish all recordings. Yeah, in this vein with this particular song that I like. Yeah, you know the history I've mentioned in a previous recording. Yeah, it's just the beginning. Folks, it's definitely not the end. It's just the beginning. And I can assure you, things will never be the same again. Never ever. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha. I love that we